treatments allow us to reinvent ourselves.
From addiction.
I haven't drank since my very first session.
To depression.
I haven't felt sadness.
It's not for everybody. It's not a magic bullet, but it does change things meaningfully for many patients.
They're allowing the brain to see itself.
In the new documentary, Can Psychedelics Cure?, scientists examine the positive effects of hallucinogenic drugs. It looks at whether it can help people struggling with a range of conditions, including addiction, depression, and PTSD.
Joining us now to tell us more is the film's director, Larkin McPhee. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for being with us.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
So, everyone, when you think of psychedelics, you think of the 60s, and that really was a turning point for any research on any good these drugs might have been doing. Talk about that.
You're so right. Nixon brought all this really interesting, critical research to a standstill with the Controlled Substance Act. But fortunately, some really wonderful pioneering scientists rekindled interest and this real resurgence right now in psychedelic medicine, because really profound things were happening back in the 50s. They were giving patients drugs like LSD to help with alcohol use disorder. And today, as our film documents, we cover patients taking psilocybin, magic mushrooms, for alcohol use, and it's having a very positive effect. So it's quite hopeful.
I would imagine in the 60s, people using psychedelics were using them to escape trauma or to change whatever was going on in their life, escape depression. And doctors probably would have said, that's dangerous. Is that what they said, or is this about dosage and the therapy in combination?
Yes. I think back then, it's hard to say, it was very recreational, and I think people were hoping to have a lot of fun, but it was also dangerous. Bad trips occurred. Whereas today, in these very safe containers with medical supervision, and patients being screened for mental illness like schizophrenia, which would not work well on these drugs, they're having very positive results now, because they're helping patients who do have pretty severe depression or have PTSD trauma, like we feature a combat veteran in the show. And then addiction, smoking, we weren't able to cover, but they're treating a range of conditions. And I think that's what's most astonishing about psychedelics, is it's not just one thing. And as we know, mental health is a huge issue in our country. So if this is another tool in our belt, it's a critical one. We really need it.
Most people think when you're treating addiction, treating it with more drugs seems like a cocktail for disaster. You always hear that addicts don't even want to take an opioid if they get injured. So how do they reconcile that?
That's a really good question. And one of the biggest differences is that these drugs are not addictive. And most people don't know that, because we're so scared back then. I mean, I remember growing up being afraid of these drugs, thinking we're going to jump out a window or look at the sun and go blind, as one of our characters says. But these drugs are, and it is ironic that we're treating recreational use of, say, alcohol with another recreational drug, but these drugs now are in the FDA pipeline, at least MDMA ecstasy is, for approval, as is psilocybin. So there's not addictive qualities. We have to be careful around toxicity with MDMA, but these are actually presenting themselves as possible therapies, and they're showing benefit to date.
Well, it's called Can Psychedelics Cure? It's streaming now. You can visit pbs.org/nova for more information. You can also visit larkinmcphee.com. Thanks for being with
us. Thank you.
Thank you both very much.